Hi guys, here's the 0.96 inch OLED display, and yes, in this video, I'm going to show you how to connect and display characters using Arduino and Adafruit library. I have an I2C interface, and that means you have to connect only four pins to the Arduino for displaying the characters. These are the VCC, the ground, the SCL, and SDA. Okay, to make the prototype, I'm using Arduino Uno, the breadboard, some jumper wires, and of course an OLED display. So here we go. First, attach the OLED display to the breadboard. Now, using the jumper wire, connect the VCC pin into the 3.3 volt of the Arduino, and then connect the ground pin with the Arduino. Okay, now connect the SCL and SDA pins. If you're using Arduino Uno, then the I2C interface pins are A4 and A5. But if you're using another Arduino, then first find out the SCL and SDA pins and then connect. I'm going to connect the SCL pin into analog pin number 5 and connect the SDA pin to pin A4. The connection is complete. Now it's time to connect the Arduino into the computer and upload the program using Arduino software. Okay, now connect the Arduino to the computer using A2B USB cable. Before you upload the final program, first run the I2C scanner. It's an Arduino code to find any I2C device addresses and to check the module to see if it's properly connected or not. Here I'm uploading the I2C scanner code into the Arduino. Yes, my display is connected properly. Here you can see the result on the serial monitor window. You can find the scanner code on my project page. I've put the link in the description. Now download the Adafruit SSD 1306 library from the GitHub. Find the link in the description. Unzip the folder and put it on Arduino library folder. Now restart the Arduino software. Go to the File menu, Example, Adafruit SSD 1306, and click the 128x64 I2C. Here's the sample code. You may only have to change this address 0x3D to 0x3C according to your I2C module address. Now you can see some graphics, text, and characters in the display. In the sample code, you have all the example functions to make your own design and graphics. And in my next video, you can learn how to display your own text and graphics. So subscribe to our Circuit Magic YouTube channel and keep watching. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you like the video and leave us a comment. You can visit our blog at circuitmagic.com to find more cool projects. Thanks.